FBI Cody. You spoke on the phone earlier.
Yes.
Mrs. D.S. Dewis.
What can I do for you? Take a seat. There's a couple of people arriving shortly from Nice.
Uh-huh. That's Charlie Morris. Mm-hmm. His girlfriend, Deborah Flynn. Mm-hmm. We know that Charlie's in this gang of high-class international thieves. I've come across him several times before, but never had enough proof to put him away. He seems like an ordinary kind of bloke, but believe me, he's a lot smarter than he looks.
What do you suspect him of this time?
Well, we've had information from the French police that when that bank job took place at Dutallier's in Nice last week, Charlie was there, on holiday, supposedly.
And what do you think he's carrying?
Well, I'm not sure at the moment. The strong room was broken into from underneath, in a very clever way, according to the French police, mm-hmm. and all the safety deposit box levers open. The kind of things they go for are money, jewels, negotiable bonds, compromising photographs of blackmail, that kind of thing. Mm-hmm. What Charlie and his pals normally do when they've pulled a foreign job like this is split up their ill-gotten gains while they're over there, mm-hmm. then bring them back individually. And when Charlie brings his share back, I want to be here when you find it.
OK, Inspector, leave it to us. If he's got anything on him he shouldn't have, we'll find it. What flight are they on?
BA223 from Paris, which should be arriving any moment now.
Yes. Do you want to go through and meet them?
Oh, yeah. I think they'd enjoy me being there. You can stay here, Dewis. Hello, Charlie. Gibbs. Welcome home, blimey. Mr. Cody. You don't look very suntanned, Debs. Spent your holiday indoors?
No, Mr. Cody. We were with our friend Sonny and...
This is an honour, Mr. Cody. What brings you here? Well, I'll tell you, Charlie. I heard about that bank job in Nice, and I thought of you. And then, when I heard that you'd been out there...
No, not me, Governor. Not anymore. Those days are long gone. We've been out there for the sun and the sea, and that's all. Mind you, I did hear about the job, and I wondered who'd done it. Bloody travel worker. So, you brought back with you any little mementos?
Only me dog, Mr. Cody, and a couple of bottles.
And you can't get us for that?
No, but are you sure there's nothing else?
No, Mr. Cody, there isn't.
Well, in that case, Charlie, you won't mind if this nice gentleman over here sees what he can find, will you? Mr. Sutton, this is Charlie Morris I was talking to you about earlier. Find out what he's got, will you?
Right, sir. Would you put your luggage on this table? You're laying on that table there. Inspector, would you mind waiting here with your colleague? John, on that table there. Sass, over here.
Can you put your case on here, please?
What do you think, Dewis? Reckon they'll find anything?
I really don't know, sir. You know him better than I do.
Yeah. Well, I know him well enough. Trying to nail Charlie Morris has cost me more than one promotion. Without him, I'd be chief superintendent by now. So, no point in harbouring a grudge, eh?
No, not so far. Come back here and we'll do work. Look, Inspector, we've gone through his thing more than we do with the average passenger. How far do you want us to go?
On a scale of 1 to 10, how far do you think you've been so far?
8.5.
Well, please carry on, and when you get to 11, tell me. He's brought something in, and when you find it, I want it.
Okay, it's your show, but I think you're wrong. I've been watching Charlie as we've been going through his things, and he didn't seem very bothered. In this job, you can sense if someone's up to something. He just sat there swigging his drink and wiping his forehead. Okay, chap.
Have you changed your mind about Charlie yet, sir?
No, not at all. But he is smarter than I thought.
Well, any luck now?
No, still nothing. We've gone through the clothing, we've gone through the toiletries and the shoes.
Look, I'll bet my pension they've got something.
Well, if you've been through everything that thoroughly, what else can you do?
The only thing left is a body, sir.
But surely you do have a standard in a situation like this.
Of course we do, and their clothing. When I say a body search, I mean an intimate body search with rubber gloves and torches.
Right, we'll do that then, to both of them, because they've got something.
You and Irene, can you come up here and do the necessary? Yeah, straight away, preferably.
I'm sorry, I've got to ask you both to have an intimate body search.
But we've already searched us once!
Not thoroughly enough, sir, I'm afraid.
It's a bloody liberty, that's what it is.
Well, if we find nothing this time, you'll both be free to go.
Look, you won't find...
Oh, come on, Charlie, let's get it done. Let me get going, I'm dying for a cuppa.
If you go with these officers, they'll take you to the examination room.
I've never known anything like this before. I'm sure it's a damn thing.
This way, please.
How long is this going to take, then?
This could take some time. You want to go and get something to eat?
Yes, sir.
I've got no appetite.
Back there somewhere.
Satisfied now? Complete waste of time, wasn't it? Now can we go?
Yes, Mr. Morris, you're free to go. Sorry for the inconvenience.
I should damn well think so and all. A good waste of time and ratepayers' money.
Charlie, I know you've got something. You may have got away with it again, but next time, eh?
You got me all wrong, Inspector. As I've been telling the Field Marshal here. Completely wrong. Come on, Debbie. Let's go and get that cup of tea.
God, I'm knackered.
Never mind, love. I've got something here that'll cheer you up.
What's that then, Charlie?
Sparklers. There's over 200,000 quid's worth of diamonds here. My share of the bank job.
I can't see nothing.
Oh, well. As my friend Michael Caine would say, not a lot of people know this, but if you put diamonds into water, you can't see them. Like ice, they just disappear.
I still can't see nothing.
Clever, eh? Even more clever than our Mr. Kodak. You lose again, Detective Inspector. Now watch this. Bloody hell!